So there's been more news on the brand new MacBook Air and the potential of it coming in March 2022 with the latest reports. Today I want to discuss if this seems possible to get our hands on the new MacBook Air M2 this side of 2022 and also talk about the specs as well. Of course, as per usual, I'll give the latest on the MacBook Air release date and price as well, but let's start with the current MacBook Air. Well, it's been over a year since we had an update to the MacBook Air. The biggest change we saw in that last model was the new Apple Silicon M1 chipset put inside and also the cooling fan being removed from the model. But this year, in 2022, some big changes are expected even further than what we got with the M1 MacBook Air. And the best way to start is with a report showing a new MacBook is coming. So, we've had a report recently showing that Apple have registered in the Eurasian database of three new Macs coming in 2022. One of those Macs has been identified as a new MacBook model, and the other two have been registered as two new desktop models. It is believed that the starting with that MacBook that has been registered, it will either be the new M2 MacBook Pro, or it could be that new designed, colourful M2 MacBook Air. Then for the desktops, it could be three potential devices. One of those devices that a lot of YouTube creators and bloggers out there are confident what it's going to be is a brand new design Mac Mini with an option of an M1 Pro or Mac's chipset inside them. The other device could be one of two devices. Once again, it could be another Mac Mini, but inside this one would have an M2 chipset inside it, just like the new MacBook Pro and MacBook Air. However, the other device, what it could be, is the new 27-inch iMac that will have a new design very similar to the 24-inch iMac, but will feature again an M1 Pro or M1 Max chipset. But that registration for a MacBook, personally, I think this could be another MacBook Pro refresh, and specifically the refresh of the current M1 13-inch MacBook Pro. Now, before this makes you all glum and down, you do have to realize this from Apple's point of view. Apple bringing out the M2 chipset in the new lower tip MacBook Pro first to get some more sales before releasing the new MacBook Air. As back in 2020 with the introduction of M1, we had that chip, that exact same chip, put inside both the MacBook Air and the 13-inch Pro. And apart from being an extra 2 hours battery life, a fan, and also the touch bar, there wasn't really much difference between both devices. So many sales went towards the MacBook Air, as it was around $300 to $400 cheaper than to get a 13-inch MacBook Pro with just that extra bit of battery life, a fan, and that touch bar. It's also believed Apple do not want to make this mistake again, and why this database registration could be the M2 smaller MacBook Pro. So, like a few of my other videos, just a quick note here. With any of these leaks, even up to the new MacBook Air's release date that I find and show you guys, a lot of previous leaks for other Apple products have come true, but there are sometimes some that get misinterpreted based on the facts that leakers have been told. I can only present to you what I have been told and shown. No leak or rumor is 100% true until we see the final MacBook Air being officially shown from Apple. However, if you are like me and if you're watching this video, then you're as curious as I am in knowing what the next generation MacBook Air is going to be like and want to know what the latest leaks and rumors are, no matter what they tell us. So, just quickly guys, recently this channel got over 300,000 subscribers, what is absolutely amazing. So in celebration of this, I've decided to do a giveaway of this. It is an iPhone 13 Pro Max and it is in white silver and it's a 256GB model option. So recently I've given away a Sierra Blue one when we got over 300,000 subscribers, and I'm going to be giving away this iPhone 13 Pro Max when we get over 350,000 subscribers. And all you need to do to enter into this international giveaway is just write down in the comments below of what Apple gear you're planning to buy in 2022. Write it down in the comments below, and also at the same time as well, make sure you subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell, because I'll be revealing who the winner is when we get over 350,000 subscribers via a video, and you won't want to miss that notification. notification for that video. Now, quickly, I just want to mention as well, sadly, there are a lot of scammers and spammers out there who use my face, for example, and also tell you to WhatsApp them. This is not me, and I'm afraid they're not giving away any giveaways out there. I'm the only one who's doing the giveaway, and you can make sure it's me by seeing that there's a tick next to my actual name. And also, like I said, that any comments or anything will have that tick, but the actual giveaway itself will be on that actual video when we get over 350,000 subscribers, not before. Well, with that out of the way, let's return back to the video. So the next question is on release date. So up to very recently, the expected release date of a device with an M2 chipset was targeted at the end of 2022. It was believed that Apple would want to use the M1 variant chipsets out on all of their devices before focusing on any M2 devices, and that could still be the case. However, recent leaks showing us registrations of those new MacBook and also those new desktops has got us thinking that the new MacBooks or desktops with an M2 chipset could be coming far sooner. Mark Gurman has reported that an Apple event is happening on March 8th, and we're now hoping for a new MacBook to be seen at this event. We have also had news that a new MacBook is coming from DigiTimes in the March time event as well. Then another report has come in from a person who leaked days before the 14-inch and 16-inch MacBook Pros came out that a notch was going to appear on them, has also said a new MacBook is planned at this event as well. So this, combined with the likes of the Mac Mini coming at the March event, it is likely that we will get our hands on this device probably in a matter of days later. If that Apple does do that event on Tuesday the 8th of March, it's very possible that the new Macs will probably get announced at that event, and then will probably be in people's hands on either Friday March 11th or Friday March 18th, what isn't really that far away. With chip shortages under a bit more control now, it is more looking like that Apple are going to be going back to their usual release method before the pandemic of getting new devices in people's hands up to 10 days after an actual Apple event. But there again, if this MacBook Pro does turn out to be the refreshed lower tier MacBook Pro, then the M2 MacBook Air is targeted towards fall this time. But moving on, let's do a summary of what the 2022 MacBook Air is going to give us with its prices. So what we've heard for the MacBook Air M2, or the new model that's coming out in 2022, so first of all, the actual display. It's going to be a 13.3 LED Retina display with a resolution of 2560 by 1600. Now, right away, the first thing you might have noticed, it's not a ProMotion display, so it does not mean it has an adaptive refresh rate. This is not going to be inside the new MacBook Air. It's going to be a standard 60Hz panel inside it, very similar to what we had with the MacBook Air M1 and like the likes of, say, the 13-inch MacBook Pro as well. So basically, no big changes there, just a normal LED Retina display inside this MacBook Air M2. For storage, it is likely it's going to be very similar to what we have right now. So 256GB, 512, 1TB and 2TB storage options. There will be that brand new M2 chipset inside it, and it is likely, according to the latest leaks, what I will cover more in other videos, to be an 8-core CPU and also a 10-core GPU at the moment. There will also be the option again of 8GB or 16GB of RAM to pick for your MacBook Air. The actual design is going to be a completely new design, as you can see here. It's likely it's going to be a little bit more thinner than the MacBook Air we have right now, but we're also going to be getting colors as a first, according to some of the latest leaks and rumors. But it will be made out of aluminium, and there will still be two USB-C Thunderbolt 4 ports on one side, and also those Thunderbolt 4 ports will be also compatible with USB 4. The new design, what I just spoke about, the new colors ranges that are coming out for it will be blue, green, red, silver, yellow, orange, and purple, what are the exact same colors that we got with the iMac M1. It's also likely we've been told that there's going to be a center stage webcam in the middle of the new MacBook Air, what will be a 12 megapixel camera. battery life is going to be the same what we're getting right now, so up to 18 hours if you use it well. And then prices wise, it looks likely that it's going to be very similar to what we have right now, with 256GB starting at $999, 512GB at $1,249, 1TB at $1,499, and 2TB at $1,849. Now, obviously, all these specs that I've just shown you here are based on what we know at the moment. This could change in the future. But next, for my wishes for the MacBook Air. My wish is to do with the colors. So we've seen some great colors in the comp sets and renders that you're looking at right here. But also there are some rumors and leaks to say that the new MacBook Air is gonna have all these multiple different colors that are gonna be very similar to the iMac and the iPad Air, for example. However, I would like to still have the ability to buy a silver, a gold, or a space gray MacBook Air like we can right now. But those are my thoughts and my current wish for the MacBook Air. However, let me know your thoughts if you agree with having this kind of choice or not. Also, at the same time, write in the comments what your wishes would be for the new MacBook Air in 2022. Well guys, it's time to wrap up this video, so if you have enjoyed watching it, please make sure to like the video, and at the same time, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please make sure to hit the subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, I'll see you soon. Bye.